So we are now going to listen to Mariana Costa. She is LATAM Fleet Service Delivery Manager at Syngenta, and she will give us a case study presentation on ensuring the right fleet for your commercial business across Latin America. She is managing a complex fleet, but has established an interesting program, so it will be sure also interesting for you.
Good morning, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you, Pascal and Steven, for the invitation and the opportunity to share a little bit of my experience. I will share my screen. Let me share. So my name is Mariana Costa. I'm responsible for fleet operations in Latin at Syngenta. For the ones that don't know, Syngenta is one of the most important players at agri-industry segment, providing innovation to protect crops and develop and produce seeds. I've been working with fleet for 7 years and really appreciate all challenges this role brings in itself. Even more in an unconventional scenario where we need to provide services in remote areas with considerable capillarity. So today I bring these five topics to deep dive regional management and how to ensure the right fleet for our business. The Syngenta's fleet in Latin America, the building blocks of fleet strategy, our current main challenges, then a little bit about suppliers, and finally the scenario for the coming years. First of all, I know the majority part of you are in Latin America and probably know that, but I think it's very important to highlight that our region includes 20 countries with high socioeconomic, political, and cultural differences. We have Brazil, that could be a continent and has regional particularities. We have Venezuela with its economic matters, and Cuba with its socialism, and Mexico with its safety challenges that impact our strategy and ways of working. Considering that, since we have been working as a regional team, our fleet operations area manages only countries with at least 30 cars here in Latin America. Are they Brazil, Argentina, Chile, Paraguay, Uruguay, Colombia, Panama, Guatemala, and Mexico. The fleet policy depends on HR and local competitors' strategy. In some countries, we provide benefit cars for managers and executives in addition to tow and pull cars. The majority part of our fleet is owned. We have leasing implemented in Brazil and is under implementation right now in Mexico. And before I present you the details per territory, it is important to remember that our business requires pickup car as a tool of trade. So this is our current scenario in Latam. In Brazil, we have 1,200 vehicles, being 75% of them GMS10 diesel or flex 4x4, 14% of Fiat Toro diesel or flex. The rest are mixed. We have as our preferred supplier for leasing AOD Automotive, but work with Localiza and LM, a local supplier as well. We provide services as fleet management, fuel card, and telematics. In LAS, that includes Argentina, Chile, Paraguay, Uruguay, we have 750 vehicles, being 59% Toyota Hilux. As it includes benefit cars, the fleet is more diverse. 100% of fleet is Syngenta's property, and we provide fleet management, fuel card, and telematics as well. But none of these countries have all the services included. And finally, inland, that includes Colombia, Guatemala, Panama, and Mexico, we have 600 vehicles, being the most mixed fleet of the region, with only 25% Ford F-150 and 23% Nissan NP300. Not 100% of the fleet is owned due to this implementation in Mexico with AOD Automotive. Fuel card and telematics are some services included as well, depending on the country. So jumping to our next topic, the building blocks of fleet strategy and its challenges. In my perspective, an operations area, regardless of each segment it comes from, in addition to work with good suppliers to support, it must focus on continuous improvement, placing its internal or external customer as the central point. However established, there are always opportunities for improvement, process optimization, innovation, etc., etc. To implement a sustainability strategy, considering fleet is one of the areas that has more impact in CO2 emissions, and Syngenta has a commitment we call Good Golf Plan 2.0 to reduce agriculture's carbon footprint and to help farmers deal with climate change and its impacts. Considering our business needs of pickup cars, lack of government incentives, and poor infrastructure, you know, Latin America, we have this scenario where we implemented, we see a long way to have a green fleet. Just to illustrate a little bit about this topic, in Brazil, where we have flex engines, much more sustainable, and there are only two pickups available with that, with flex engine. The manufacturer's strategy is to direct it to retail segment, to work with reduced production of this type of pickup, not to invest in for pickups, to invest in this kind of engine. So we don't see attendance in a opposite way. Then the next, to think global, act local. It's hard to implement a regional supplier, for example, for telematics, the same model of car, because each country has different mix available and different opinions on that. A leasing model as well, due to different financial figures, and the list continues. So, but it's important to have this as a base of our strategy. And finally, to have a safety culture where we implemented and reflected in the daily behaviors of drivers. Considering fleet represents the highest company risk, Syngenta moved at the beginning of this year fleet operations structure to HSE, our health and safety area, and created a road safety area to work focused on strategies to have this risk reduced and saved as driver's base. We also have a program in Latin that started in Brazil some years ago. We call Camino Seguro. That's very important to us and a benchmark to other regions and other companies. I will show you. So it evaluates drivers applying a monthly score based on specific safety behavior requirements, such as speed, telematics, infractions, seatbelt, no usage, night driving infractions, driver under alcohol influence, handle cell phone while driving, and preventable incidents. At this point, the results show us a big difference between countries of Latin America, for example, Brazil and Argentina. Since telematics infractions until the imposition now fines by agents. So the consequences for safe driver, we recognize them in a scoring platform that drivers can redeem prize. For unsafe drivers, we can apply a formal warning, one-on-one talks, driver retrainings, or the worst, in my opinion, a bad evaluation on annual performance. This is a great achievement of this program because it affects HR evaluation and bonus payment. So it's good. Our next topic, the main challenges. I guess with COVID-19, the first one turned on the biggest for fleet managers. Current market of uncertainties with vehicles unavailability, long lead times, prices variation, not say inflation. It has been so hard to deal with manufacturers and to suit our internal clients' expectation. TCO analysis, this could take the entire session. I'm sure it's a big challenge to all of us. We have in one side indirect procurement team with global agreements, some particular strategy like standardization, trying to get some financial operational benefits with fleet ops, of course, at this side, and the other side, the business, who in our case has the decision in its hands. They are the budget owners. So they take into consideration a local view and in most cases goes against what we received from the global team. So at this point is where we must influence and show effects in data, our TCO analysis and recommendation. And finally, fit for purpose. In February, it's beautiful, but for sure, it's very difficult to implement in practice. I hope this will change one day, but car is still a status item in Latin America countries. Last year, we developed an indicator that takes different variables and assigns some weight for each one. So we conduct a discussion per area considering their particularities. It was very welcomed by stakeholders. There is no way to invent the wheel when we talk about a TCO analysis, but if I could give a tip, for sure I would say, use objective premises, adapt your approach, and show to your customers that you are taking their needs into consideration. I know we have a lot to do, but we are in the right way. So the next topic, suppliers. This is also a good subject that we could deep dive and discuss for a day. But today I want to bring in our view what differentiates a good supplier from others. First, I think the capacity of supporting fleet in a regional global perspective, respecting local requirements. It links to the blocks of fleet strategy I've brought before. Then, a deep understanding of business needs in order to solve problems. It's not too easy to find a supplier that really wants to hear our needs, vision, problems, and transform these inputs in improvements or solutions. So then, consistent KPIs and access to information. I really want to see someday a supplier that shows not only trivial information, but dashboards that provide us an overview of problems and opportunities. And finally, linked to this topic, proactive recommendations. So going to the last topic of my presentation, what we see for the future scenario. Hybrid and electric car are also linked to our challenges to have a sustainable fleet. and our one of the most important blocks of our strategy. We see on the news that is a prospect to have this kind of pickup cars in the coming years, but will they be accessible for us, to us? And my question is not only from financial perspective, but everything that comes from with a huge change like that. Spare parts, production volume, infrastructure, and the list goes. Then cost reduction. Day after day, this is one of the biggest challenges for fleet managers. Once we are only a cost line, right? So the pandemic just made it worse with fuel prices, car purchase prices, spare parts. That is my next topic. We have in Brazil, for example, Ford closing its manufacturers plant and a forecast to have a lot of dealers closing or changing their branding flag. And it will impact directly on after sales services. So COVID-19 transformed a lot all the supply chain as well. And finally, to close my presentation, I see a huge space to be explored by suppliers and fleet managers in data analytics. We are behind that in that area. Thank you, everyone. Hope you enjoyed and see you later.